All right, this is MMAScoops.com. I'm sitting down here with Trevor Prangley. This is Ryan McKinnell. Trevor, how you doing today?
Good, thanks. How you doing, Ryan?
Oh, I'm all right. Just living the life, I guess. Have a few questions for you. After your loss in the UFC, you won a 5 in a row. Now, that's got to be a nice feeling. But I know Mr. Lindland came in and called you out after your fight. How you feeling about that? Yeah, for sure. How are you going to fight Lindland? Obviously, I don't think you really want to go to the ground with him, but I mean, what are your thoughts?
Lindland, you know, he's got to go to the ground. I don't know if there's many people in MMA that can actually stop his takedown, but the defense is self striker now at the moment, so hopefully he tries to go that route a while
and
get knocked down, you know?
Yeah. Is there any idea when that fight's going to be, or not really? Yeah, definitely. So if he takes another fight now, are you going to want a fight just to stay busy, or are you just going to be...
Of course, I like to fight all the time. I've been fighting a lot, but I'd like to fight 4 to 5 times, maybe even 50, you know what I mean? I just want to keep busy. I've got 3 years left of my career. I want to fight as much as I can.
Understandable. Did you say you got 3 years left? That's what you're planning on?
Yeah, I'm 35 now. I figure 38 is a good time to retire, you know what I mean?
Yeah, for sure. That seems like a good number, as good a number as any, I suppose. So, Trevor, what intrigued you about Bodog? Was it the show on Ion, or was it a fresh start, or what?
It was a fresh start. You know, I came up with 2 losses in the UFC, and, you know, even though I lost, everybody knows I was tough. I had a real hard time finding fights. I just fight almost a year. About probably 9 months, I was looking for a fight. Looking for a fight, I had a couple of fallout. Bodog gave me a shot at a fighting coach week, and I took it. I really enjoyed working with them. I had 2 fights with them for the first time, and after that, I won those 2, one against Gola, the other one against Seminoff, and then, you know, we signed a contract after that, and I think they did me well. I'm happy to be with them.
Yeah, I also heard that the Calvin, you know, really takes care of the fighters when you guys go down there, that he really puts you up nice and takes care of you. Right.
He's a good guy. I mean, he sets the fight. He takes time to talk to every fighter, you know. And he genuinely is a fan of sports, so good.
Right. Well, like I said, I wanted to talk about that IFC Global Domination. It's kind of become a legendary night of fights in the underground just because of the competition that was in it. I know you were in it. I also am aware that you lost. But in a night like that, and especially since it was your first loss, you know, against Bob Alou, I mean, when you look back on that night, what are your thoughts about it? I mean, were you happy to be part of something that special?
Of course, you know, look at the names in there, some huge names, and then, I felt I did all right against Bob Alou. I just feel like I fought my best fight. I didn't concentrate enough on stopping the takedowns. I'm a better wrestler than I showed in that fight. And managed to go the distance with him. You know, that was probably my first A-level fight. And it opened my eyes to where I was born and what I had the capabilities of doing.
I completely agree. That fight, it was a hell of a fight. You went the distance. And look at it this way. I mean, Bob Alou goes on that same night in the next round to beat Shogun, hands him his first loss, and then goes on to beat Horn. So, you'd like to think that maybe, I don't even know if Fedor would have beat him on that night.
Yeah, you know, and then if you read his interview, he said I was his toughest fight, so he was glad to get me out in the first round. But...
Well, that's got to be a compliment.
It was. I was happy about that. You know, you learn a lot from a loss. I learned one thing that, you know, I walked in there 200 pounds away from his go-to, I believe. And I was eating, trying to keep the weight on, and Bob Alou was cutting 14 pounds to make weight, and I realized that that put my last fight at 205 at the A level, I realized I can't do it. You know, I have to cut down to 185. So it was a big turning point in my career.
Yeah, I completely agree. That's actually when I first became aware of you as a fighter. So I imagine it did that with a lot of other fans. Go ahead. Okay, what else? Sorry.
Yeah, I'm done. Go ahead, man.
Yeah, we got the delay going on. It's all good. What were you going to say?
No, I'm good. I just said, yeah, you know, that's when I think I started to get noticed. What was after the Bubba Lou fight, you know, but I don't think a lot of people thought I would go to distance have such a tough fight with him.
Right, right. Okay, so who are some other fighters out there? In Bodog, I'm assuming, or maybe some other organizations besides Lindland, of course. Who would you like to step in the ring with?
Yeah, I'd like to step in the ring with whoever is ranked above me.
Right.
I believe I'm a pretty underrated fighter. You know, I believe I should be in the top 10. I think I can beat anybody in the top 10 on any given day. Which, I mean, it works both ways. You know what I mean? But I believe I can say that with everybody. I've proved it with everybody I've fought. And, it irritates a little bit that I'm not ranked up there. So I'm like, I think somebody's up there to be a top five guy. So I don't even know who they are ranked. Whoever's there, I'd like to fight.
Well, that's a good attitude. That'll get you in the top 10 in no time. Now, I also understand that you've left AKA, American Kickboxing Academy.
No, not at all.
I
trained down in Las Vegas just to help Phil Baroni for his fight, and I ended up in American Kickboxing Academy.
Oh, okay. I got info from one of your press guys. Different. That's my bad. So you're still training at AKA.
Absolutely. Yeah, as far as I'm concerned, the best team in the country. You know, everybody talks about Greg Jackson, he's talking about Miletic. But if you look at it, we might not have a champion in UFC. We've got a champion voting out a champion probably for it. But if you look at our overall winning record, that team just doesn't lose. You know what I mean? We might lose one here and one there, but we never lose the winning team. So I would never leave that team.
Yeah, that's why when I heard what I heard, I was very surprised, but it's good to hear that that's actually not the case. So you got your big names at AK, but who are some other guys maybe over there that we should watch out for, hard hitters, etc.?
At AK?
Yeah.
Yeah, we've got a couple of up-and-comers, you know, but I don't know if you've heard about Kane Velasquez, the new heavyweight champ. He had one fight with Bodog in the Russian show, you know, and unfortunately broke his hand, so he's healing that up now. But everybody says tough, you know, I'd hate to pick a guy out. You got Koscheck, Fick, Quick, Bobby Southworth, Phil Baroni trains there on top. I mean, there's just so much talent there. It's hard to pick a guy who should watch out. You should watch out for the whole team, I think.
Yeah, and it seems that Koscheck's about to be the man of the hour here coming up in about a month. What are your thoughts on that fight with him and GSP?
I think it's a tough fight, but I think Koscheck can beat him. I think Koscheck's mentally stronger. I think GSP shows a little bit of weakness, you know, when pressure gets put on him. If you look at the fight against BJ Penn, where he didn't want to come out for the second round, his corner made him. He actually admitted that, you know.
Right.
Like that just shows a little bit of there's a potential for breaking there, and you're not going to break Koscheck. So I give the edge to Koscheck, although it's a very little edge.
Yeah. Do you wrestle a lot with Koscheck when you're out there? Is it as good?
I train a lot with Koscheck. Not really wrestling, but a lot of ground game. His ground game phenomenal. Obviously, his wrestling incredible.
Right.
I don't like to go from a feet with him. It's too demoralizing.
All right. Well, before we go, Trevor, you got any sponsors you want to thank before we get out of here?
Yeah, I want to thank all my sponsors. Actually, you know, the guys have supported me down through the years. So I got the Renegade Fight Gear. They're on board now. They're toe-to-toe with me. With me for like three fights. MMA Jack just got with me. Payne Inc. with me since the Bubba Lou fight. You know, I didn't have Brawl this time, but they're always there with me. And, you know, I know I'm getting somebody, but if I did, I apologize. And, you know, lastly, I just want to thank the Savior, Lord Jesus Christ, for turning my life around and giving me the ability to fight. You know, I don't believe he gives you the victory, but I believe he gives you the ability to do what you do.
Well, all right, Trevor. Well, good luck and best luck in the future, and thanks a lot for taking the time out to talk with us.
Thanks for having me on, man.
No problem.